What's going on YouTube? Effect Records here. Today I'm bringing you an awesome video. I just got this in the mail. What this is a EasyGuard Smart Key PKE Car System Alarm Push Button Start System. So what that means is I walk up to the car, automatically unlocks, I get in, push a button, don't even gotta do anything with my keys, get out, leave. Once I reach like 15 feet or something like that, it'll automatically lock the vehicle back up. It also has remote start and all those options as well included. So I'm pretty stoked to get this on my 2008 Mitsubishi Lancer. That's what this is going to be going on. So let's go ahead and unbox it and see what we got in this. As you see, it is a nice box. Like, I like this box. I think it's a nice quality personally. It gives you an EasyGuard instruction user manual. Here's a wiring diagram schematic. Here is common uses and operations paper. All right, so this is the two key fobs, if you want to call it. They feel pretty decent quality for me. Like, the buttons feel pretty nice. Yeah, to me they seem pretty good. For the price that I paid for it, I bought this whole kit on eBay for $125, free shipping. To me, they seem pretty well made. So yeah, pretty stoked at this. Well, so far anyway, I guess. But there is the keys. Let's see if I can get this out. This pops out. Here is the control module in the EasyGuard system. So you have some connectors back there, some connectors back there. And bear in mind, when I go to install this on my 2008 Mitsubishi Lancer, I've never installed one of these before, so this is going to be a first experience and seeing how hard it is on a difficulty level and stuff like that. So, yeah. Pull this out. Alright, so here is some antennas. We have, I think, two of these? Yes. It looks like we have two antennas, one for the front of the car and one for the rear of the car. And this is basically, I believe, to communicate with these remotes right here. So yeah. We have various wiring. Like all that. And here looks like a smaller antenna. This is a high frequency antenna. I know that's what that says. And these don't say anything on it, so. Here is the keyless entry, I believe this is what this is. Because it also has a keyless entry for saying, like, if I give my fiance or family member the key password and I don't want to give them the actual key, I can just be like, type in, you know, the number that I come up with, and they can unlock the car from that perspective. Or if I even, for some reason, batteries run out my controller and my car's not unlocking by itself, I can do it this way as well. Alright, and here's another connector. Looks like I gotta put this one together. Oh, that should be fun, right? Alright, and then here is the push button start. So I'm gonna take this out and see the quality on this. See if this seems cheap or not. The link will be down in the description below, so you should check that out. Alright, here's this. I believe this is what uses it to secure it on the factory ignition. But here's the button itself. It has some wires in the back. Now, I'm not entirely sure, but this button seems a lot cheaper than the remotes do. But as long as they're cool and it works and it doesn't break, you know, anytime soon, I'll be fine with it. It just seems kind of clunky to me, but other than that, that is what's in the box. So let's go ahead and put everything back the way I found it for the most part. Put that right there. Put this back like this. This on top of this. Just like that. Let's go head out to the vehicle so we can start taking apart my dash panels and basically prepping it, getting it ready to install my PKE push button start system. go ahead and unpackage this and we'll lay it out. So I'm hoping this only takes today to do it and then maybe part of tomorrow because I got today and tomorrow off work. So that is awesome. Let's go ahead and put the antennas together. There. Scoop this over there. Now here's some zip ties that I can just chill back there. Empty box. Push button start. Here's the keyless entry. Go ahead and put that over there. And there's stuff. Push button start. And got this little fitting right there. Close up the box and set that aside. Probably put that up there as well. I got the other one on my keychain already. Remember when working with the electricity inside the vehicle to be sure to disconnect the negative terminal. That just prevents any shock shortages and stuff of that nature. Let's go ahead and do this real quick. The first part to the game plan is to remove all this trim off of the vehicle. All of it needs to go, including the steering wheel common so I can get access to the ignition and all that stuff. So that is the first step that I'm going to do, is just remove all the trim that I think is necessary to remove, because I do believe there's also wires that I need to get to in the kick panel, so I'll remove that as well. There's usually a screw right there, but I done took that out and just didn't put it back. Some just same like there, so if you'd do this on an 08 Lancer, there'd be a screw right there you'd want to take out as well. Put the stuff in the back seat. Three screws right here. Now this thing just pulls out, so if you give a little oomph, they should release these clips that's in the rear of it. Push in, then you can pull down, and then you can release this little guy right here by just pushing in the little clips that's right around here, and your glove box will come out. So after you go ahead and remove this panel here, there's going to be some screws right here you got to take out. So after you take out those screws, you can go ahead and pull on it and it should pop out. Just like that. Now for me, since I got these switches that I put in here, I'm going to go ahead and push those through. Three. So now I got three switches out, and then I got this panel that I can throw back in the rear, just like that. Alright, so now you're going to want to take out two screws at the bottom of the steering wheel column, and that should be able to pry off just like that, and to remove this whole outer casing so you can get to the ignition switch and all that fun stuff. just like that.
Top part, bottom part, set that in the rear as well.
So for this, I'm going to go ahead and cut these wires and then strip them so that I can connect them to the ignition switch system. So let's go ahead and do this. Okay, so once those are all stripped, now we're going to make our way over to the ignition switch side and pull up the plug, strip that, and then start stripping those wires as well so that we can start connecting these. I found a wiring diagram online that shows me all of these wires that I basically need to use to hook up my push button start PKE passive keyless entry system. So that link will be down in the description below to be sure to check that out if you're doing it on this kind of vehicle. If not, I'm sure there's one out there that you guys can look up, but yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and hook up these.
There's no turning back.
Yep.
Shove that right into there like that.
Alright, so now that the ignition switch has been wired up, so that's ready to go. Next on, I gotta move on to the next step. So let me grab my instructions and see where I gotta go after that. Alright, YouTube. So we ran into a problem with this push button PKE passive entry start system. The issue is this. Like, seriously, that is a big issue. Just a tangled wire mess issue. So I gotta figure out where all these go, put them there, and then, yeah, basically what I'll do is I'll probably just hook them up, and then I'll bring in the video back later, because I don't have anybody to hold the camera and stuff like that while I'm doing it, so that I will show you guys and basically tell you where I put them all at, so that if you want to do this on your Lancer, it'll be easier for you guys. But yeah, this is just a big, massive issue, and I'll still give you details on the difficulty level, 1 out of 10 scale. So yeah, that's where I'm at on this. So I'll see you guys when it's all hooked up. Hi, what's going on? I'm back. I got it all installed and hooked up for the most part. Obviously, it doesn't look pretty right now, but I'll get to that level. I just wanted to show you guys basically what I did to get here. If you have a 2008 Mitsubishi Lancer, it may be different for your vehicle, as I do have a manual transmission. I'll remove this cover. So that's my stick shift. So I didn't really hook up the brake because I didn't need to, because it won't let me start my vehicle anyway unless the clutch is held in. So I didn't really worry about that. So I do have this extra brake wire, but if you have an automatic, go ahead and hook that up to your brake safety switch. For the Lancer, it's a red wire. I just didn't go ahead and do that. I may do it later, I don't know. But anyway, what I had to do was I had to disconnect. This was my ignition switch wire. I had to pull that out, and that's what this long strip is here that connects to that. I just basically got my wiring diagram, hooked that up, heat shrinked it, electric taped it, and it's looking pretty good and it works well. Let's see what's next. Here's some ground wires on these yellows. This is for my door. Because if I take my key, right, here's my key. Oops, let me focus. If I hit it, and then unlock. And as you see, if I hit it, locks, unlocks. So that's my door ground wire. And these, what are you doing? You better go play. Anyway, the other part of the door wires are these white wires with fuses. The white one is, I believe, the closed circuit, and the white and black is the open circuit. And to those wires are right over here on the kick panel under this brown connector. You'll see a brown connector, and the yellow and red wire is for the closed circuit, and the gray wire is for the open circuit, I believe. So you just basically tap into there. What else? I have the horn. The horn is wired right here. It goes up to a green wire that's wired right next to the airbag switch, stuff like that. It goes to a green wire. I basically made it longer, and then it goes to this pink wire that's labeled horn. That's for the beep noise, for confirmation. I got an antenna right up there. I got an antenna back there. I got this antenna. I'm not entirely sure where I'm going to place it yet. And then I also have the keypad thing right there. I don't know if you can see that, but it's right there past my, on the glass windshield. And that looks like this on the outside. So that's for the keyless entry. For some, whatever reason, if you need it. I don't know if I'm going to keep that on or not, but that's where it is. What else is in here in this mess? Okay, what else I did was there's also a key in the ignition. I don't know if you can see that. But there's a key that had a cut to stick in the ignition so that the steering wheel doesn't lock. It's on the on position. And since it's not hooked up, it doesn't really do anything except prevent the steering wheel from locking up so I can actually drive the vehicle. And with that being said, once you put the key in the ignition, it'll say remove key on the dash lights right over there. It'll say remove key. And to how to fix that, I totally guessed at this and it worked. So I was like, sweet. I unplugged this thing right here. And once you unplug it, it'll say remove key all the time. So all that I did was I jump two wires together, and basically it stopped, like the it went away. So what I did was I just cut off these two wires. I got this, it looks to be white and red and a black wire. I ended up cutting those off, and so the key doesn't say remove key or whatever, so then you could just plug that back in. That's basically that. I'm trying to see if there's anything else. Uh, I know the passive key entry lock works really well. I'll give a demonstration once I put all this back together on how it works. And see, I got that right there. Lights up for the push button start that takes place of the key area. And what I did for that is that it came with this weird bracket I didn't know how to work. So all I did is I stuck it in there. And then on the back side is Gorilla Tape. And I taped it back there, and it works perfect. It doesn't move. There's no play. It works really well. So yeah, let me go ahead and put all this back together, and I'll show you guys how it works. All right, so I got it ready. All right, so now I got all my panels back put back together right here. Everything looks good. And there is my push button start. Now if I take it out of my pocket, see if I can focus here. All right, so that's the key. All right, so that's the push button start activated. Okay, so there's the push button start after I put everything back together. All the paneling is back on, stuff like that, floorboard and all that. And I also vacuumed out the carpet, made it look professional, pretty and stuff like that. So yeah, if I go ahead and take my keys and lock the door, unlock the door, lock, unlock. So it's integrated in the locks and unlocking of the vehicle as well. If I hold in the clutch and hit this start stop button, and then it starts up. Shut it off just like that, and if you hit it once after it shuts off, all right, so it'll say goodbye after you shut it off, and then you can hit it once, which turns it on, and then you can hit it again for the on position. All right, so you can hit it once to turn on the ACC, and then hit it one more time, and then it's on the on position, and then if you hit it a third time, it shuts off. So that's how that runs. But yeah, this is basically the video on how to install a push button start on a 2008 Mitsubishi Lancer. You can also use the same steps for different vehicles as well. I wish I would have got more in depth with soldering all the wires and heat shrinking all of those together, but it's kind of hard with no one to film that close in depth on the wires, and you have a bunch of wires to do. But if you like this video, please comment, rate, and subscribe.